Dear Becky, as I'm writing this letter, I know I'm nearing the end. By the time you read this, you'll be facing probably one of the worst feelings you'll ever experience, and may even think the pain won't ever go away. However, you need to know that in time the pain does subside, even if it's not fully, but you will feel better. I don't want you to live life as though you have lost something irreplaceable. I want you to celebrate my life by living yours to the fullest. Explore. Live out your dreams. You can't live within the restraints of your fears, Bex. You gotta let go of your worries and do what makes you happy. Since you're reading this, that means you're now aware I left everything in my name to you. I hope the money will provide the means for you to get out there and dive into whatever you want to do head first. I know gathering up the energy and confidence to do this may be difficult at first. So I want you to meet with someone who I think may give you some encouragement. My cousin Steve will be meeting you at the coffee shop down the street at 1 p.m. on the 1st of next month. He couldn't be more opposite than you, but just give him a chance. I hope by the time you read this letter, it isn't too late. But remember, it's never too late to start living, to start doing what you really love doing. All my best, Jim.
Tomorrow?
Thank you.
Would you like a cover or a straw?
No, I'm good.
Thank you.
Oh, man, really? If you weren't standing right behind me, that wouldn't have happened.
Really? That's your sorry excuse for not.
Well, did you need to be practically up my ass?
I'm sorry, are you one of those guys who have to be right about everything, or you can't fucking admit when you're wrong?
Thanks.
Hey, it's okay. You look really pretty today. What can I get for you?
I'll do a large iced French vanilla with cream and no sugar, please.
Thanks.
You waiting to meet someone?
Yep.
You wouldn't have me waiting for a guy named Steve, would you?
How do you know that?
Because I am Steve. You must be Becky.
Seriously?
Hey, at least you look good in the round.
There's no way that you and Jim share DNA.
Yeah, never heard that one before.
Are you this obnoxious all of the time?
I'm sorry, did I offend you?
Do you mean, did you offend me when you spilt your whole damn coffee all over me and didn't even apologize? I don't know, Steve, would you be offended if that happened to you?
I'm sorry, that was a dickhead. I didn't mean to-
Yeah, it was.
Make it up to you?
You know what? I'm not even sure I want you to.
I could sing to you.
No, don't do that. Please don't.
Please
no.
Forgive
no.
me.
Shh.
I know not what I do.
Okay.
Don't
no,
deny
Steve,
me this pain I'm going through.
Okay. All right. Okay. I accept your apology, okay? Just sit down.
So, let's plan what we're getting into, shall we?
We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
Thank you, you too.
So, I know Jim left you pretty much everything. You decided what you were going to do with the money?
Well, I was actually thinking. I have always wanted to tour Europe, and so maybe I'll take a month off and explore what's out there.
How would you do that? That would require so much money you can't ever get back.
Well, that's what he wanted me to do with it. He wanted me to go out and explore and live my life and enjoy myself while I still can. I mean, you only live once, right?
It's such a waste, though. I mean, yeah, it's a great experience, but don't you want to set yourself up for success first and think about a vacation after?
Well, what do you suggest I do with the money, then?
Something that benefits your future, like buying an investment property or putting in an IRA.
You don't have to make me feel so stupid about it.
Wasn't trying to, just trying to help.
Well, I mean, look at what happened to Jim.
His life was unexpectedly cut short, and he didn't get to do half of the things that he wanted to do, and so now I have to do the things that I want to do while I still have the chance.
But he was still happy and able to live his life comfortably. He didn't spend his money foolishly.
Ugh, you do not have to be such an asshole about this. I mean, like, sure, you can plan for the future, but you don't know what's actually going to happen, and you don't want to look back at the end of your life regretting the fact that you didn't get to do what you wanted to do. That is no way to live your life.
And since when are you in the position to lecture me on how to live life?
I don't know, Jen. I mean, what if he's right? What if it's stupid to spend money on a trip?
Well, didn't Jim say in the letter that he wants you to be happy? I mean, he basically gave you the money to help you do things while grieving his loss. Isn't it up to you to decide what makes you happy?
I don't know. I guess, I mean, what if he has a point, though? Not having to worry about future investments and having a permanent place to live would be beneficial.
True. But you'll never know when you get a chance to go to Europe again.
I know. You're right. Well, the good news is I have time to think about it. So, I'm gonna try to get some sleep.
Definitely sleep on it. Call me tomorrow. Love you.
Love you too.
Hey, Bex. How you holding up?
You know, I'm hanging in there. And you, how are you doing?
Just trying to keep myself busy.
Yeah, I hear that. I actually was spending some time with Jim's cousin, Steve. Did you ever meet him?
Oh, I remember Steve. They couldn't be more opposite, huh?
Yeah, that's for sure.
Yeah, Steve's a good guy, though. He had it a lot rougher growing up compared to Jim.
Really?
Yeah. His parents were in a tough spot for a while. His dad had this accident at work that left him partially disabled. His mom couldn't find any work at all. Jim's parents helped out the family for a while, but as you know, they had their own tragedy with that car accident. So then Jim helped them out for a bit because everything was left to him. At least until Steve got onto his feet.
Wow, I had no idea any of that happened.
Yeah, I'm sure you know Steve's actually pretty successful now. He had to work really hard to get to where he is today. You okay?
Yeah. Sorry, I keep spacing out. That seems to be happening a lot recently.
Yeah, me too. It's still just... It just doesn't seem real, does it?
Yeah, I know.
Well, I hate to cut this short, but I gotta run to this appointment. It was great to see you again, Bex. Don't be a stranger, okay?
I won't. Take care, Mike.
All right, take care.
You really came here to give me a new shirt? You only live once, right?
Thank you. No, you don't. I got a sudden shift today and hit the car. Just walk like you normally do.
Almost not so perfect timing there.
This was a perfectly timed door answering.
Really? Because a second ago, I almost used your face as a door knocker.
Irrelevant. I know it takes you 20 minutes to walk here.
You only say that because you saw me walk up.
I didn't need to see you walk up to know your mom had another surprise shift today.
How could you possibly know that? Because your mom always has surprise shifts.
You would think her own daughter would know her better than this.
Oh, shut up! Like, I literally can't wait to just, like, own a farm. Animals, huge garden and all.
When did your garden suddenly turn into an entire farm?
I don't know what you're talking about. It has always been a whole-ass farm.
Oh, really? A whole-ass farm? You can't handle all that shit.
I've managed yours so far. What? There's no need to be jealous. You'll be there, too.
What do you mean?
Well, obviously, it's going to be your farm, too.
I wouldn't leave you out on such a sweet deal.
What if...
But this is all after we go through community college, of course. I mean, we're here! Sure, we started late, but finally here, and it's finally time, and then maybe afterwards we could road trip a little bit before we get a cat and rent an apartment. But the lease can't be for more than a year, and it would have to be in the next town over, since that's where all the farmland is. And while we save, we could scope out potential... You good? Because I was...
Yeah, you. You were just planning.
I mean, I was just brainstorming, you know, it doesn't have to...
I'm going out of state for college. I applied without telling you and I got the acceptance letter back. I'm sorry for not telling you sooner.
OMG, that's awesome!
Really? You're not upset?
Of course not. I'm just shocked is all. It seems so sudden. When do you leave?
4 days from today.
That's awesome! I wish I had known sooner so I could plan something for a farewell.
Don't worry about it. Our usual sleepover at night is all I need. I don't need a big, crowded party when your company is all I need. And you know that. I know we'll be apart, but the distance is nothing. I'm not gonna abandon you on the community.
Stop it. Stop it. It's fine. You're fine. She'll be gone, but everything, everything will be the same. Nothing's going to change between us. It'll be okay. Just be there for Tara. Just be there for her. It's all okay. She doesn't want her friendship to change either, so it won't. It's okay. It's okay. Everything's going to be okay. You're okay. It's okay. Everything's going to be okay. It's okay. It's okay. Everything's fine, it's okay.
Shit.
It's okay, I'm okay. You're okay. It's fine, everything's fine, everything is fine. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay. You're okay. okay.
Hey, what's up?
Nothing, really. Just making sure you haven't left yet.
You can't get rid of me that easily. I still got 3 days.
I can't even imagine getting rid of you. Speaking of, for our movie tomorrow, I was thinking we could...
Oh, I was actually hoping we could do it at my house again this week. I know it's your turn, but I've got to finish packing and I'm already behind. It would make it easier for me. You can still pick the movie, though. Also, I would be lying if I said it wouldn't be nice to have our sleepover in my room one last time before I head off.
Oh. Yeah, of course. No biggie.
Really? Thank you so much for understanding. Your support means the world to me, Quinny.
There's really no need for that.
I gotta go pack now, but I'll see you tomorrow.
No, yeah, absolutely. See... This is really happening. I need to convince her to stay.
I'm so sorry. I completely lost track of time. Packing's been crazy. I'm sorry.
It's okay, really. Can I come in?
Oh, yes, yes, of course. I'm sorry.
There's really no need to keep apologizing. But you know...
What?
You wouldn't have to deal with all this chaos if you just stayed.
Ha ha.
My room is sort of a mess, and no, you don't get to comment on it. Come on, it's not that bad. Quinn?
Sorry, just shocked is all. It's just so...
empty.
I guess so, but I just want to take as much as home with me as I can.
Then take me with you!
You wouldn't fit in here.
Chop me up into little pieces first.
I'd rather not start my new life with a criminal record.
Your new life, huh? Your new life on the run, maybe, because one way or another, I am fitting in this box.
So what movie?
It's your choice.
Quinn. Mm. Quinn, get up. We can't sleep like this. For our necks.
Why'd you decide to leave?
There's just so much I want to do that I can't accomplish here.
Yeah? Like what?
I'm trying to grow as a person, and I'm too comfortable here. If I stay, I won't be able to break out of my shell.
But you hate discomfort.
That's the issue. I can't face unfamiliar situations. I need to face discomfort so I can overcome the barriers it creates.
But if we just stay together, then you'll always feel comfortable, and you won't have to deal with any of that in the first place.
I know.
Then stay.
I can't.
Why am I not enough for you anymore?
You are enough.
But you're leaving because you want more, something I'm incapable of providing.
That's not true.
You're abandoning me!
I'm not leaving you, I'm leaving for myself!
What changed to make all this happen? Did I do something? We had this whole idea of going to college, getting jobs, living with each other. And then, all of a sudden, you hate the idea of me being a constant in your life.
That's because you never asked if that's what I wanted. You just planned and planned, and I was too much of a coward to say anything.
But
it's always just you, though.
How am I supposed to just magically know what you're thinking when you never said anything in the first place?
And that's the issue. I need to grow so I'm not afraid to say something. I rely on you too much to do so here.
Oh, is it bad to rely on each other now?
That's not what I'm saying.
So you want to leave so that you won't need me in your life anymore?
None of this is about you, though.
When your grand aspiration revolves around the closest person to me in my life deciding to just leave me alone out of the blue, yeah, it's also about me.
What are you doing?
Leaving, clearly.
You can't leave now.
Why? You are.
This isn't the same thing at all.
I'm helping you out. I'm giving you a head start on that no-quit lifestyle you want so much.
Fine. If you are this incapable of thinking of anyone but yourself, maybe you should leave.
Oh, like you're one to critique selfishness. So much for friendship.
Thanks for supporting my dreams, friend!
No. Oh, I'm so sorry, little guy.
What are you doing here? I thought you left already.
I turned back.
But why didn't you leave again when no one answered the door?
I figured you'd be back eventually.
Would you like to come in?
Your flower. I didn't give it the love and support it needed and deserved.
Well, what was there isn't completely gone.
It'll be a different geranium, sure, but it'll grow strong from what was already there before.
So, are you saying I could fix what I ruined?
It was never ruined in the first place.
I'm so proud of you.
Live from the Howard's Athletic Center comes the first presidential debate. Here's our moderator, William Johnson.
Good evening. Welcome to the first of the 2028 presidential debate between Senator Jessica Richards of West Virginia and, surprisingly enough, an unnamed write-in candidate from an undisclosed location. I'm William Johnson. This series will be consisted of viewer and audience-submitted questions, as well as questions by myself. Let's introduce the two nominees. Senator Jessica Richards. And is that right? Huh? What is that right? Okay. And next we have the Possum King. I find it only fair we begin with a few opening remarks to introduce each candidate.
To my fellow Americans, I humbly aim to serve the greater good of America moving forward. I promise that my policies will fix the problems facing America today, will improve and rebuild upon what we have in place already, and I promise I will do everything in my power to ensure that America is worthy of the title, greatest country in the world.
Thank you, Senator. Mr.
My fellow people who live in America, listen carefully to what I'm about to say, because I know exactly what many of you are thinking. Who is this guy? How did he get here? What does he want? What does he smell like? I'll gladly clarify. We, as a people, have been straight up not chilling. And I just want to make sure the vibe is dope as fuck again.
Okay, well, I welcome the candidates to the debate. Let's not delay anymore and get right into it. Based on the current state of affairs, how do you plan on reinvigorating the economy and ensuring the success of our nation moving forward monetarily?
Well, Will, if I may, following the directions my policies plan to take, I believe we can get America back on track in no time at all. Meanwhile, my opponent, might I add, has remained a mystery for a majority of the time leading up to this point. He's offered nothing suggesting he can monetarily support this country and its future endeavors.
Fair.
I'm sorry, what was that, Mr. Possum King?
I said, that's fair.
Would you care to elaborate?
Yes, I would, Willie.
Well,
excuse me, ma'am. Don't interrupt. That's just fucking rude.
Yeah, wow, that is kind of rude.
Quinn, don't side with him. The Possum King's a joke.
He may be crazy, but at least he knows proper manners.
Mrs. Senator, please let him finish.
I, with the support of all my cool people and friends and supporters of America, would create a new form of currency that would be utilized all throughout the country.
What does that even mean?
Yeah, still my turn. Thanks. Maybe just wait for it's your turn to talk.
That doesn't make sense, and it's completely...
You're mad.
Why would I be mad?
Because you're not smart. Think, who controls the value of the dollar? We do. It's simple math. We say how much you can buy with a certain amount of money because we figure out how much it costs in our minds. See, really, it's just paper. So all we have to do is just say that our new money is worth more than the old money is.
Structure Initiative is planned to start this year, funded by the U.S. Treasury Department. More at 11.
Ugh, you gotta be kidding me. They want to build a what? Where the hell is all that money gonna come from? Did you read what the government's doing in the newspaper?
I have never read a newspaper in my life. Especially when it comes to politics.
They want to spend millions of dollars on shit we don't need. I mean, they got all the smartest people in the world working for them, they still can't figure it out. I'm a carpenter, even I know what to do. What are you watching anyways?
Presidential debate.
So you won't read the newspaper, but you'll watch this.
This is really interesting. This guy is fucking nuts.
Well, who is he?
Calls himself the Possum King.
Sounds like something I would have come up with on one of my crazy acid trips in college.
You've done acid? Wait, you've been to college?
What's he saying?
That is in no way how money works. I hope to our Lord and Savior that no one actually believes that any of this will actually work.
You know what? That's fair. I've been saying a lot of crazy stuff for the past 20 minutes. But hey, that's just me. I rant when I get worked up. But I got another idea that's even crazier than all the rest. How about we just stop spending all the money you taxpayers give us on shit we don't need?
Didn't you just say that?
Well, he's got a point.
Look, one of my policies will put a major increase in taxes towards the members of society who are considered the 1%. Now, many before me have attempted this, or said they would try, but to no avail have they succeeded. If elected, I will lobby into Congress to place measures to ensure that the shadowing monopolies plaguing this country are squashed, and we see a real turnaround in the economy.
That brings us to our next point. How should the next president tackle growing animosity between the American taxpayer and the government?
My turn. I got the buzzer before she did.
What the hell is that? There's no buzzers. How did you do that?
I brought it myself, you slow fuck. All right, these big companies forget that the power rests in the hands of the people. So with this in mind, if I become the president, I'll put the word out, okay? Any big time monopoly as CEO, people will be called out by me to meet me at a specific time right in the front lawn of the White House, where I'll be waiting, dukes up, ready to go. And straight up, if these rich pricks aren't willing to stand for their company, we as a people will burn everything they have to the ground. Now, I know this may sound extreme, but if they do show up, I promise it'll be a fair fight. Even if they're old or not at the same fighting capacity that I am, I will intentionally give myself a handicap to level the field. For example, if they're above the age of 70, I'll tie both my hands behind my back. If that son of a bitch can get past my whirlwind headbutts and defeat me in a 1v1 combat, then he will not have to forfeit half of his personal finances back into the economy.
So you plan to beat up old men for their money?
No. I'll beat them up for America.
Into the economy.
So you plan to beat up old men for their money?
No. I'll beat them up for America.
Well, fuck yeah, about time someone did it. Hey fellas, come on over here and take a gander at this crazy son of a bitch on TV. He's got some crazy ideas, but I kind of like him.
I mean, that was insane, right? They were just going back and forth, and now they're just like...
Honestly, if that applied to my boss, I'd be cool with it.
Yeah, your boss is kind of a dick, huh?
Yeah.
Hey, what did I miss?
He's an idiot. This is stupid. He's stupid.
Well, I just found this poll collecting data from social media platforms, and right now, Possum King is ahead. Still think he's stupid?
20 books say he still loses.
Deal.
And what if they're a woman?
Ooh. Possum King just went down.
Ha! See?
That is fair. Are you saying that you would headbutt a woman in the face to lower taxes?
Well, Jeff, that's a solid point. And honestly, that's a tough answer to give. I couldn't do that. Not even for America. But that's why I let my lovely wife handle it. She's just as passionate about this as I am. Matter of fact, you can see her over there. Give me a wave if you're cool with that, honey.
I guess I'd be okay with that.
I mean, so long as it means we get free healthcare, why not?
Yeah, and if it combats climate change and, you know, fixes the pay gap, I'd be okay with it.
Me too.
Ooh, and Possum King just shot up higher than before.
Scoreboard!
Damn right, baby. I love you. Mwah. See, what I'm trying to say is...
No. This is completely ridiculous. This man is a fraud and a lunatic. That is not a real way to combat taxes. In fact, it's probably the most psychotic thing I've ever heard.
Look, I understand what you're saying, okay? And I think that, one, you're lame. Okay, you're probably the worst to have at parties. Like, no fun at all. And two, what I really think my idea boils down to is that what America truly needs in a president is a champion. Someone who's truly willing to fight for the people. I mean, how can you trust a president who's not willing to Mike Tyson a 75-year-old man's ear off or to let his wife engage in a bare-knuckle street brawl to ensure that our kids get the best education they possibly can? Personally, I don't think I could.
Okay, next question. Let's talk about education. How would you plan...
Ding, 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 buzz, buzz!
Ah, damn, she beat me. Well played.
Uh-huh, yeah. What was the question again?
How would you improve education?
Well, I would, through my policies, enact a plan that would see the costs of tuition as well as expenses associated with being at the collegiate level go down, so that all students have equal access to education. I would also put forward incentivizations to improve public education at the high school and lower levels. This would include classes that would not only prepare them for that level of education, but life in our society. Classes like managing finances, paying taxes, applying for jobs, many life skills that most young people don't learn until it's thrust on them in the real world. Yeah, what do you think about that?
Honestly, it's not a bad idea.
We're running a bit longer than expected, so I think it's about time we open it up to a new segment, which consists of viewer and audience submitted questions. Now, to the viewers, we ask you keep the questions relevant to the debate and the candidates on stage. Each response will be limited to 30 seconds. Let's begin with the senator. Mrs. Senator, in your political opinion, what political party animal mascot is the best?
What?
That's 30 seconds I'd like to steal. The best political mascot is mine.
What would that be and why?
Simple. My party's mascot is the praying mantis. The reason why is because if it's the size of a man, it could eat and kill a full-size elephant or, you know, any other land animal, so.
Senator, a viewer is interested in knowing what you find to be your best quality and or skill you find yourself most proficient at.
Probably my sense of right and wrong. Also my understanding of the law, as I am a bar certified attorney.
Mr. Balsam?
Honesty. And being better at anything than my opponent.
Oh, fuck you.
What? It's true. I don't lie. I just said so. Also, fuck you, too.
Oh, yeah? Oh, if that's true, why don't you name all 13 of the constitutional amendments?
That's easy. The first, the second, the third,
oh,
the fourth.
No, no, no. God damn it.
Mr. Balsam, a viewer asks, what is your favorite type of kick?
Yes.
Oh, I'm getting word we're running out of time. Now, for both of you, if you please, let's wrap this up with some final remarks, starting with the senator.
To my fellow Americans, despite everything we've heard tonight, and the obvious joy and laughter had at the expense of myself and the people in attendance, and while I'm sure this man has entertained you, I ask that you please go out and vote for who you think will bring adequate change to America and the world. Someone who will listen to what you have to say and do what's best for all of us. If it's not me, then find someone else, so long as they bring something to the table. I genuinely believe that you will all see what really matters and make the right decision and vote for who you think is best.
Well said, Senator. Possum King, your closing remarks.
I'll keep it short and sweet, like my slogan. If you want to see some awesome things, vote for the Possum King. And I'd also like to introduce my running mate, who's the mayor in a small town in Minnesota. Duke the Dog Mayor!